What's up, guys? I am in the middle of a tile floor right now. I've done one bathroom so far. So I've got basically the rest of it is kind of the kitchen, the living room, and a couple halls on the way out of the door here. So let me turn the camera around and show you what I'm doing and how to use your Challenger for tile. Basically what I do, Challenger makes a brush that goes under the machine where you can scrub tile with. I don't have that right now. I need to get another one. That's what I need to do. So what I'm using today, I'm using my Auric, which works really well for it. And in some cases, better because it'll fit between things that, you know, that the Challenger won't. So, you know, for close quarters, it works really good for that. But let me explain to you how I'm doing my tile here. All right. This is the big living room. So basically I'm going to be cleaning my way. I did a bathroom, you know, beyond there a while ago. But basically we're gonna do this all the way to the front door and through the kitchen. So right now I've got a mixture of 20 volume peroxide, basically a gallon of 20 volume peroxide, a gallon of Zip floor stripper, a quart of 40 volume peroxide, and the rest is water in a 4 gallon sprayer. The tile is not very dirty, so you almost don't need all that, but I wanted to try the 40 volume peroxide because I haven't used it yet. So spray that down and you let it dwell for a little bit. Then you run the Auric over it, scrub everything really well. If you don't have an Auric, you don't have anything like that, you can use just, I've got a scrub brush down there, but basically, let's see if I can zoom in on it right there, that yellow brush. You can use that guy to do the grout lines, but you know, that's gonna take you a minute to do all that. So this particular way is, hang on, I'm trying to get. All right, now I think I'm back to good there. Okay, so basically you spray it down, let it dwell, you agitate it all, and then once it's all agitated, you don't let any of it dry. If you let it dry, you gotta start all over again. So basically you leave it wet, then I run over it with the shop vac. I pick up everything off the floor with that, and then I finish with the Challenger. I put one of the terry cloth bonnets on it, and I spray it with vinegar, and then I towel over everything with the Challenger, and I neutralize the floor, because when you put down floor stripper, your pH is probably 14, so you need to go over it and neutralize that. So I'm going to show some of the scrubbing here, and then I'll show some more of the cleaning or the pickup. I'll show some of that, and then finally the running over it with the Challenger rather. All right, I think that should be tall enough. Hey, you wanna wear no slip shoes because it is slippery.
store for a little bit. Is there anything you're gonna need from me anytime soon?
Do what?
I'm gonna run to the store for a little bit. Is there anything you're gonna need from me anytime soon?
I'm good. I'm good. All right.
I think we've got the gist of the situation here. Basically, scrub until, you know, now if it's not really soiled, you're not gonna see the soil break loose from the tile and grout, from the grout situation. If it's just moderately soiled, it'll change colors. And basically, you go over that, you extract it, and then you run the Challenger over it, get the rest of it, and then when it dries, you'll get the brand new look. So you don't get the immediate instant gratification that you get when you use a spinner and you use hot water extraction. That gives you the instant gratification everybody likes to see. You won't have it with this method. You don't get that instant gratification. You gotta work for it and then you gotta wait for it to dry. But it's never failed. It always works great and I always get a bunch of compliments and a good review when I do it, so it always works well. You just have to work a little bit harder at it, but I don't try to stack them deep to where I need to work fast because I don't have any interest in working fast. I'm making a video to go up on the internet for everybody to see, and watching me haul ass through a job and do half-ass work is not what I'm interested in taking part in. So anyway, I'm gonna do the rest of this, and then when it comes time to vacuum it up, which will be in just a little bit, I'll turn the camera back on and we'll watch that, and then I'll run the Challenger across it. Challenger. All right, now we're to the Challenger portion. Trigger sprayer, you spray out. I've already been spraying out some now, but basically you spray it everywhere. The vinegar, and then the Challenger will take it wherever it needs to go. Thank you. Let me excuse the fans. The kitchen and the dining area were just done. So letting that dry a little bit. We'll go back and look over everything here in a little bit. But right now I've got to do this little hallway here, through here, into there, and then behind me here. So what I'm doing now is I'm basically staging my getaway so I don't have to walk back across my clean tile. Moving everything basically out here, out of the front door. So make your getaway out here. Things going well. I'm just kind of in my own way right now. The kitchen's drying just fine. We'll take a look as soon as we're done. And the kitchen is the telltale for all of it. That's where most of your soil is always going to be. So we're going to spray here and all of this right now. And then go back and scrub it all, then extract it, and then run a Challenger across it, and that'll do it. Easier said than done, but that'll do it. We're all done here. All of this has got to dry yet before it's going to look really, really bright and shiny, the grout. So I put all the fans on the dirtiest part of the floor, which is the kitchen here, so we can get down and look into the grout line here. That's what you're looking for. The whole place was done like this. And when you do it this way, you soak the grout a lot longer, so it takes longer for it to dry. And as long as it's wet, it still doesn't have that brand new look to it. It'll look like over here, there's one that hasn't quite dried yet. It has a little bit, kind of a darker look to it. But as everything dries, and it happens very slowly, it starts to take on the brand new look. It's like right here in front of the stove, and we're all back to the brand new. So it just takes a little longer patience here, and you have to explain that to your clientele so they understand, because like the other areas that the fan wasn't on for so long. I was just coming from outside, my eyes are kind of not focused yet, but I see basically in areas where it hasn't dried, it'll still take on like a darker look, and it doesn't look like it's clean, and it won't for another hour or so. But back over here where it was really, really good and dirty, that's all done. All the floor was done with a super strong peroxide and floor stripper, so dirt just can't hang on through all that. If you're looking to buy a Challenger, you can go through me, and I'll send you a $100 rebate and give you a free ride-along training, and also basically a lifetime of text support. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. God bless, and I'll see you in the next video, which is going to happen here in about an hour.